Roosters crow. But people talk. The human voice is the instrument of speech and song in all the languages of the earth. Yes, for better or worse, human beings can talk. Articulation.
Peter Piper picked a peck of pickled peppers. Where's the peck of pickled peppers Peter Piper picked?
The ability to communicate ideas to other people is something everybody needs.
Articulation. 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 Articulation.
We only have words to try and transcend the gap between thoughts and the world, and most of the time they fail to do justice to our real intentions. I've been chasing this unicorn I'm calling
ultimate articulation
for quite some time now, and what that pretty much means is the ability to have a thought or way of seeing translated to the external world, i.e. other people, while retaining as much of its original integrity as is humanly possible, that necessitating a brain transplant. Most everything I do towards that goal seems to lead me to the utilization of language, of speech, of the spoken word. Dr. Jordan Peterson once said,
there's nothing you can possibly do to become more deadly than to improve your facility with language.
We develop language as a tool to tell one another there's a mammoth behind you. We've now transcended that and can use the tools once allocated purely for survival. So much more than just that. Think about food. Consider cuisine. We went from a carcass over the campfire to ratatouille and creme brulee. Isn't that something we have to think about? How we further that chronology? I mean, Colonel Sanders seems to be doing a fine job of gastronomically speaking, but I mean with words, expression, speech. We're so limited in how we're able to articulate the intricacies of human existence. And I know what you're going to say. Well, isn't that where art comes in? Someone else's attempt at understanding the world, at articulating the world, we're given access to a potential
Eureka,
that's it, moment. You're sitting there watching the screen and the protagonist says something, does something, complemented by the composition or the costume design or the set design, or maybe you can't seem to be able to pinpoint what it is exactly about, but something within it, within the film or the novel or the song or the painting, something within it spoke to you. It made you point at the screen or the page and proclaim, that's it. That's exactly how I feel. That's it. That's what I want to be more like. That's it. That's why I am the way I am. Isn't that what art is? An attempt at furthering the chronology of articulating the human experience, of trying to wrap our heads around this thing we've been thrust into without so much as a murmur of consent, this thing called life. And through this, you could call it through what you could call this perpetual effort of Herculean proportions to tame words, I've come to realize that English, yes, Your Majesty's English, may be on the lowest rung in regards to being a language of emotional capability. Yes, the roses are red and violence is blue. Just slap it next to German and the never seeming ever to be over vocabulary to handpick from. Take this, listen to this. The English language has 171,000 words in it, currently in use, give or take. And the German language has, take a guess, you're wrong, 5.1 million words. The sheer mathematical advantage Herr Schneider would have over Mr. Smith is there. In the math, more words equals a higher possible chance of articulating oneself with the least amount of damage in transit from mind to mouth. And I'm not talking about going out and learning German and Japanese for the love of God. What I'm trying to say is that unless you're proactively fighting the uphill battle of mastering words, then the you want the world to be acquainted with, the you that you want to be, isn't going to exist. Because in order for him to exist, he would have to speak the way you want him to speak.
I mean, last week was rough. Are you kidding? Last week I looked up my family tree, two dogs were using it. I tell you, I can't relax, you know? Well, the other night I was in a place, I felt like having a few drinks. I went over to the bartender, I said, surprise me. He showed me a naked picture of my wife.
The point is, we, us, you and I, blood, flesh, we have possibilities, ideas, capabilities that we can't convey with words to its ultimate truth. And I'm not talking about truth and truth or their truth. I'm talking about an ultimate truth, a divine truth, a truth that's out there. I've always found that people who love things and passionately love things and are able to articulate why they love those things to be the same people with the ability to set themselves up for a life of contentment unaccompanied by the parasite of chronic dissatisfaction. Loving and knowing something, whether it's God or lasagna or cinema or New York City or Charlie Parker, tends to be the first step towards what people have overindulged of hyperbole as life with meaning. Do the best with what we've got and then do some more. I mean, I really truly believe that the path to a life of content lies in articulation, in being able to bring words and art up against the cold indifference of the cosmos, in holding that up and proclaiming, you see this? This is what I was trying to say. This is me.
There are many pictures of him in the family archives.
Chives? What about
his
Chives?
His life is really a